Hey, what's going on, team? It's Ricky with Tech But Solutions, and these are my three reasons why, if you're a beginner when it comes down to learning how to trade in the stock market, that I think that you should completely avoid penny stocks at all costs. Hope you guys enjoy. All right, penny stocks. So let's talk about it. Why do beginners, when they begin to start investing in the stock market, do they start with penny stocks? Well, I think one of the biggest misconceptions is that, you know, just because you have a little bit of money to start with, that you need to trade stocks that are relatively less expensive. And that's not necessarily the case. One of the biggest factors that I think so many people fail is because they begin with trading penny stocks. And if you look at majority of the penny stocks that are in your watch list, I would encourage you to just do this analysis. Look at them on the 180-day 4-hour chart, giving you a better understanding of what their direction is. I think, again, one of the biggest reasons that people fail is because majority of penny stocks are descending patterns, making it that much more difficult for you to enter, exit, and manage your risk accordingly. When you're someone that's just getting started, you are struggling to identify when's the proper time to buy, when's the proper time to sell, and when's the proper time to manage and cut losses. Having the overall direction not in your favor, meaning that it's descending and making lower lows and continuously selling off, is not something that is added value. It's actually something that's playing against you. Let's say that you're someone that's, again, just getting started. You're still struggling with your entries, exits, and stop loss. But big picture, then you begin to invest or trade a pattern that's continuously showing signs of an uptrend. With time, that ascending uptrend pattern will most likely end up exceeding your initial purchase price, making it that much easier for you to be able to sell for a profit, because what? The direction is in your favor. When it comes down to penny stocks and usually lower cap stocks, the patterns are aggressive descending patterns, making it that much more difficult and having the actual direction simply playing against you. All right, and the last thing that I want to cover is the sole reason that you began to learn how to trade in the stock market. It's, you know, you most likely saw that someone made with a smaller sum of money a pretty high return, right? And yes, although that is very attractive, there's a huge learning curve when it comes down to trading. And the only way that you're going to be able to get to that point, to be able to take advantage of those opportunities, is to understand what it is that you are doing. But I think when it comes down to just getting started in trading or investing in penny stocks, because there's so many odds against you, the probability for you to even make it and still see value in trading in the stock market, you know, 1, 2, 3 years down the road, is so slim, because so many people get simply discouraged when trading penny stocks. Because not only due to the learning curve and due to the time and the lack of the monetary return that you're not going to see necessarily right away, you tend to experience a loss. And let me give you two examples. Let's say we have a low cap stock, and let's say that we have a higher cap stock. Normally, one of the deadly qualities that a penny stock offers is volatility. And although that can play in your favor when it comes down to you actually knowing what it is that you are doing, when it comes down to you not understanding why to buy, why to sell, or where to cut losses, it makes it that much more difficult for you to understand the overall movement, price action, and where you should buy for a good deal and where you could sell for a profit. And because these are lower cap stocks and the volatility is so high and they can be easily manipulated, the price movements, when it comes down to the percentage, can be huge, and I mean huge. BPTH is a perfect example. It pushed up over 500%, reaching a price over $70. Then a couple days later, pulling back to under $20 per share. So just imagine that percentage loss for all those that backheld. They didn't understand what was going on. They simply didn't understand that it was super overbought, being manipulated, and that most likely in just a couple of days or even just a couple of hours, it will simply begin to pull back because the overall hype just simply isn't there. So now let's take into consideration a mid to higher cap stock. Let's say something that trades around in the $50 price point. It's a reputable company. It offers a much more consistent pattern, but yes, the percentage return is not necessarily huge. When you're just getting started, I would have such a smaller focus in how much money it is that I'm making and have a much larger focus on ensuring that you understand every action that you take. And the reason that I think that if you're someone that's just getting started, being able to focus on these mid to higher cap stocks, the overall direction, pattern, and overall movement is in your favor. And the thing that I really want to focus on is movement. As you're learning how to identify when it's a good time to buy for a good deal, when it's a good time to sell, when something is oversold, or when something breaks its pattern and simply you have to cut losses, because the overall movement and the way that that mid to high cap stock moves at a much slower rate, it gives you the time that most likely newer traders need. So in all honesty, I can go on for an hour on YouTube and simply talking about not only based off my experience, but other reasons why that I think that if you're someone that's just getting started, when it comes down to learning how to trade, when it comes down to penny stocks, it's just not in your favor due to the overall volatility and the learning curve that you still have to go through because of the quick actions that you have to take. Again, like they say, you have to learn how to walk before you could run. So like we know, when it comes down to learning about any new market, you're going to have questions as you're going through the material. So let's say that you're someone that's part of the Learn, Plan, Profit course. As questions come about, not only do you have the ability to direct message me within the Learn, Plan, Profit private Discord chat, but also because you get to watch me trade live every single day, you can ask me to show you examples or to break down the top stocks that you see value in and to give you my 2 cents on why I or do not see value in what it is that you are breaking down and actually show you in real time. Like we say, practice makes perfect. And I think that you guys can all agree that because of that huge learning curve, that you're simply going to need that practice. So again, be sure to dedicate time, be sure to be patient, be sure to be consistent when it comes down to learning about any new market. I want to thank you guys again for your time. I also want to remind you that the Tech Buds staycation, which is the 2-day visit of where I fly you out at the end of the month to spend 2 days with me and the Tech Buds team, ends on March 31st. So all you have to do is simply enroll in the Learn, Plan, Profit lesson library. If you guys have 5 minutes, I understand that you guys might be busy, 5 minutes. Click the first link down below, and I would love to see if you see value in being able to work with me on a closer basis and watch me trade live every single day. We are the largest YouTube channel and the largest private Facebook group for those who trade in the stock market, and I would love the opportunity to work with you on a closer basis. I hope I earned your thumbs up. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hope you guys can subscribe, and like always, let's make sure that we end the year on a green note. Take it easy, team.